Good morning. I'm Janie Parrish with the Wadsworth Area Chamber of Commerce, and we're zooming into business. And today we're zooming right down the street from the chamber office to the law firm Palasek. I got to make sure I get this all right. Palasek, McIlvain, Hoffman, and Morse, LPA. How'd I do?
Wonderful. Brownie points for you today.
Okay. And we're speaking with one of the attorneys, one of the partners, Linda Hoffman. So hello, Linda. Good morning.
Good morning, Janie. Good to see you.
You too. Well, we got lots to talk about for your law firm. So first of all, are you a partner with the law firm?
I am. I'm the managing partner. I'm happy to have been affiliated with the firm for nearly 35 years now.
Wow. I hope you got a gold watch out of that.
Not yet, but I'm working on it.
Okay, good. So tell us about, I'm going to say it again, Palasek, McIlvain, Hoffman, and Morse.
Wonderful. You've got it. Well, we are Wadsworth's premier law firm for both individuals and businesses, and we've been offering legal services to the greater Wadsworth community since the early 1970s. We have collectively over 100 years of legal experience with the attorneys on the firm, and we represent folks in Wadsworth, Rittman, Medina, Wayne, and Summit counties. So it's nice to have attorneys right here in your hometown. You don't have to drive to Cleveland or Akron to get your legal work done. You've got people that are in the communities where you play and pray that are your neighbors willing to help you with your legal issues.
So I was going to ask you what's unique about your law firm, but you've answered some of it, but is there anything else you want to throw in there?
Well, I would say one of the things that's unique about us is, you know, law firms are not that different than medical offices in that we deal with people with some of the most sensitive and private matters of their lives, whether it's individually or operating a business. And it's important for our clients to know, whether they're businesses or individuals, that we take very seriously our attorney-client confidentiality commitment and know that when you bring your business here, it doesn't leave these four walls. And often when I'm out in the community and I see a client, I tell them, I won't acknowledge you unless you want to acknowledge me, because you may not want someone to know how it is that you know that attorney. If it's a matter that is of a personal nature and maybe not so positive, you want to keep that private. So we're just really pleased to be able to do that and to do that in a wonderfully historic building here, just a couple blocks off the square.
You know, we receive calls at the chamber office and people will ask us about attorneys. And we always give them, of course, the attorneys that are our chamber members. But that's one of the questions we get most often is, oh, I don't know if I really want to go to an attorney in Wadsworth. And we know your reputation, and we always explain that what it's kind of like what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas, and what happens at your practice stays at your practice.
Right. And that's true. You know, the attorneys have that commitment to the confidence, as does our staff. And, you know, we find right now we're fielding a lot of calls from people with the pandemic. They're looking to update their estate planning. Maybe they're needing to take care of a family member that's ill, and they're realizing they don't have the powers of attorney in place. They don't have an estate plan in place, or the one they have is outdated. So we're happy to do that. And what better place than to have your friends and neighbors who know you and know your business to help you through that? Especially a lot of what I'll say are the mom and pop businesses who often are dealing with other family members, and they may have talked about a general plan around the kitchen table or at holiday times. But when one of the top two people in that business becomes ill, suffers some other tragedy and isn't able to operate the business, don't you want someone that has a shared vested interest in your success here in town to help you with that, to make sure you've got a smooth transition plan? And we can help them, again, whether it's somebody doing work for their own estate planning, that of a family member, or they have a business, they're a mom and pop, or they're an LLC, maybe they're a landlord, they have some rental properties here that they're having issues with. And then we also represent some larger businesses where we can help them with employee issues, personnel manuals, things like that. And I think having and knowing your friends and neighbors in the business community is an asset. We share wanting you to be successful.
Because when we have people that come to the chamber and are interested in starting a business, we always tell them that's one of the three people that you need to have is a good attorney. Mm-hmm. And so, and we often recommend, we can't, you know, like be favoritism, you know, kind of thing, but it's still, we know your reputation. And sure. So that's awesome.
Sure. And a lot of times people almost, when they come in, it's almost a badge of honor. They'll say, well, you know, I've never had to see an attorney before. And sometimes sure. That's good. But when you are making important decisions on things like buying a home, starting a family, starting a business, taking care of things for an elderly family member, those are important things. It's a lot easier to pay that attorney up front for the advice than to come in after the fact with a signed contract or finding that you got yourself in a situation that you say, oh, I know I probably should have brought this into you before, but can you do anything to help me now? Sometimes we can, but it takes a little longer and it's a little bit harder to do.
Sure. So why do you love what you do? Because 35 years, that's awesome. So why do you love what you do, Linda?
I think attorneys by nature are problem solvers, and I'm a problem solver. I like to help people with whatever issue it is that they bring. And I think the other attorneys in the office share that same passion. We're not cookie cutter. It's not a one size fits all. We start with what is your goal? What is it that you want to have happen? And we'll walk you through a series of options and steps to get from where you are to where you want to be. You know, years ago, for example, in the estate planning world, there were seminars all the time telling people, get living trusts, do living trusts. And for some people, that was what they needed. But we also saw folks that spent $2,000 or $3,000 for living trusts, and they didn't really have a legal reason to have them. They didn't have a tax issue. They didn't have a family privacy issue, and they had very few assets. But you know, sometimes it is appropriate, and we just ask, what is it that you want to accomplish, and then how can we help you get there?
There you go. Now, how can people find you?
Very easy to find us. If you are in the Wadsworth area, as I said earlier, we're just two blocks south of the square. We're at 273 Main Street, right at the corner of Pine. Now, due to the pandemic, we're limiting our in-person visits, sure, but we are doing video appointments, telephone appointments with folks. They can call us at 330-334-1536. And they can check us out online. We've got a great website featuring all of our attorneys and a little bit about our services. And that's at www.pmhmlaw.com. And we're open, like most businesses, Monday through Friday, 8:30 to 5, and other times by appointment.
Okay, so before we go, I want to know, what was the building that you're in? What was its original purpose?
It was the corporate offices for the Ohio Injector Company, and it also served part-time as the home for ConValve, which was a company that made huge valves that went into submarines and supply lines like the Alaska Pipeline. And for a short time, it was the temporary home for the Wadsworth City offices when the new City Hall and Courthouse area was being constructed. So it's got a very interesting history. It was vacant for several years before we had the opportunity to purchase it and make it the new home of our firm. And it was a great thing to be able to come back to the south side of Wadsworth.
And now you've got some great things going on in the south side of Wadsworth as well. Yeah, you've got the new Water Main Grill, the Wadsworth Tavern is a fun place to go. And now there's a new junk store down there, which is for overstocks. So great things are happening in this.
Absolutely.
of Wadsworth. So, well, Linda Hoffman, thank you so much for talking with us today. It's always a pleasure to talk with you. And I love your passion for what you do.
Thank you. And when the pandemic's over, if folks are in the area and they just want a tour of a really neat historic building, stop in and we'd be happy to take them around.
Perfect. Okay. Thank you.
Thanks.